Welcome to part two of understanding your soil analysis, how to act on your test results. Part one gave us terms and definitions on the report, and you should make sure and tune into that one before watching this video. Your soil analysis comes with the book, Understanding Your Soil Test Results. Get out your chart, get out your booklet, and let's follow along. The first part of the results you'll look at is the organic matter percent. Organic matter usually comes from decomposing plant matter and helps with soil drainage and holding capacity, aeration, feeding the soil food web, and more. Organic matter and other nutrients are affected by the cation exchange capacity, or CEC. If your organic matter is in the very high range and your CEC analysis is over 20, you should not add anything, but wait for the soil food web to break down the organic matter already there. If your organic matter is high and your CEC is less than 20, you need to help the organic matter break itself down into nutrients by adding either Arctic humus or a mycorrhiza. Next to, and related to organic matter, is nitrogen. This is important for plant growth, but too much can also be harmful. If you have high organic matter, your soil will get some nitrogen from that as it breaks down. Good sources of nitrogen include blood meal, fish meal, and cottonseed meal. Or planting a cover crop will fix nitrogen. See our video on how to plant a cover crop. If you have too much nitrogen, plant corn or other heavy feeding crops, such as roses, lettuce, tomatoes, squash, cucumbers, and cabbage, to help use it up. Whether you need to add nitrogen will depend both on what the analysis is and what you are growing. For vegetables, you should add nitrogen if it's less than 40. Use the chart in your booklet to determine the rate. Orchards, vineyards, and lawns require less nitrogen and don't need any added unless the analysis is less than 25. But before applying the fertilizer, you'll also want to look at your levels of organic matter. If your levels are very high, some of your nitrogen is tied up there. You may want to consider adding a slower release nitrogen like feather meal instead of the fish meal. This will give your plants a slower feeding of nitrogen. Also keep in mind that most organic fertilizers contain other nutrients. For example, in this biofish, it's 7% nitrogen, 7% phosphorus, and 2% potassium. You may want to review your entire soil analysis report before choosing which nitrogen fertilizer to use. The next nutrient on the chart is phosphorus. Phosphorus is important for flowering, fruiting, and rooting. Good sources for phosphorus are bone meal and rock phosphate. And phosphorus is usually slow release, so be sure and add it in advance of when your plants will need it. There are two readings for phosphorus on your soil analysis report. Refer to the phosphorus weak Bray reading to determine your level on the chart in the soil analysis booklet. The other phosphorus reading represents your long-term phosphorus reserves and should be monitored over time as you follow up with subsequent tests. If your phosphorus levels on your analysis are low, medium, or high, add phosphorus according to this chart. For very high readings, do not add any. Potassium is the next nutrient on the chart. Potassium is a nutrient that helps support overall plant vigor and supports metabolism. A reading of below 150 is too low. You can add potassium by adding sulfate of potash, according to the chart. It is possible to have too much potassium in the soil. If your potassium is high and your CEC level is under 20, you will need to add gypsum at 5 pounds per 100 square feet to help remove the excess from the soil. For the macronutrients and the trace elements, refer to the easy-to-comprehend book. If we can help answer any further questions about your soil analysis, please contact our gardening consultants and Grow Organic for Life.